Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. And today I'm super excited because OpenAI just released amazing new models, right? And it's called O1. We have two options, O1 Preview and O1 Mini. What we are going to do is, in the classical format, test them against their current model, which is ChatGPT-4o. We're going to see how it performs, how these models are actually better in reasoning-based processes, and also see how fast they are. Now, again, we already know that they are comparatively slower compared to ChatGPT-4o because they do a couple of turns of thinking process, kind of thinking process, and put that together. But we're just going to see how much difference can you actually expect when you're using these models. In addition to this, you need to understand these prompts that I'm going to use are going to be super simple. I'm expecting a normal user should be able to use it in the same format without learning any prompting skills and technically get better answers just because the models are better. So it's going to be super simple prompts because they have already mentioned there is an advice on prompting that you can see on my screen that, you know, use this. And they don't have a lot of features right now. They don't use images. It's only text right now. But very simply, we're just going to use it for simple prompts and see how they perform. So that if you're a user and if you don't know prompting, you should be able to use them and just get probably better answers. Okay, so let's get started. And I'm going to show you my screen setup, how it works. So on the left-hand side, you have O1 Mini. In the middle, if I just move myself, you have O1 Preview, and then you have ChatGPT-4. Oh, awesome. So let's get started. We have a very simple prompt. I have a LinkedIn post that I wrote before. I wanted to figure out new format of writing that post with new information for companies to utilize ChatGPT. So write an engaging LinkedIn post on how can help business owners in all sizes, from small businesses to multinational corporations. And in addition to that, I've also written, I wanted to find new ideas which were not referenced before so that it should not reference everything that I've already input, right? So let's see what it comes to. Now, my idea had a WhatsApp sales bot, an FAQ bot, or a customer support bot, mostly chatbots, right? And if you can see, there is a new feature. You can see how it is thinking here. And you can see the response of GPT-4o is just directly updated here. So personalized marketing campaigns and tailor augmented automated meeting summaries, advanced data analysis. This is pretty basic, but also very important, which you can use. But if you see here, you have a thought process now in Mini and Preview, which is actually the feature of these models, which are it's actually working and thinking through in steps, right? So I'm working on a LinkedIn post titled this, I'm brainstorming unique cases, enhancing business operations, spotting ChatGPT's potential, cultivating continuous learning and everything else. And let's see what it is. Supercharge your marketing content creation. That is great. Transform your customer feedback into actionable insights. Streamline internal communication and reporting. That's super great. Enhance employee training and development. Innovate product development and AI brainstorming. Compared to GPT-4o, this just blows it out of the water. It's too good. Literally, it's too good. I'm seeing this for the first time. I've not tested it out a lot because the limit is so low on testing these models right now. And then you can see on, let's say on the left-hand side also, on the O1 Mini, automated content creation and marketing, streamline recruitment and HR process, enhance data-driven decision-making. So again, decent, it took three. This is probably done a bit more thought and created something different because I wanted to create something different. And you can see there are five options here. I technically like the O1 Preview model content a lot much better. A lot of those are similar, but the point is I can technically copy and paste this post on LinkedIn and it just works. Here, I'll have to change it, make it more give it a couple of more examples. This is very based on how a LinkedIn post should look like. This is great. Okay, honestly, preference, it's my personal preference. You might choose something else. You have the answers on your screen, but I really, really like that. Again, I think I stopped to stop the timer, but very, very good responses from Preview.
Okay, so that was super awesome. And 110% O1 Preview gets full marks for that. So I'm going to give that. And I'm pretty sure 4o is not going to win from these models. That's obvious. That's pretty obvious right now. But the idea is we're still going to test it. Now, the second question is they said that it's super good for programming and they have also tried it with Devin. We're just going to use a simple example where I wanted to create an HTML game. Now, this is something that they showed in their test. So actually, I want to see how it goes. So let's go. 3, 2, and 1. I am pretty sure this should take them a bit more time and I'm going to show you all three results, right? And all of this should be in one file. I really want it in a single file. I don't want to copy and paste, create multiple files. I've already mentioned that. And you can see as much as ChatGPT-4 is kind of getting done, but Mini is already done. O1 Mini is already done at around 15 seconds. It's taking ChatGPT-4 over roughly around, it's still going on. So 24, we are at 24 seconds. And again, given that they already mentioned that O1 Preview is going to be more time taking, it's taking its own sweet time, but even 4o, in comparison, is actually taking the same amount of time. So 34 seconds for 4o, Preview is still going on. And I think it's done. Is it done? Is it done? Yep. Let's see. So 42 seconds. So roughly like around like, you know, mini, O1 mini is probably the fastest one. And like, you know, if the output is better than 4.0, then I'm sure like, you know, you should probably just start using that model much more. So I'm going to show you all the examples. Let me just paste it together and give it a second. But I'm just like super surprised to see that O1 preview took like 45 seconds. And the answer should be like I would expect it to be like, you know, a bit more better. Might not be, it might not be, and it's completely fine, but let's see. So I'm just going to show you exactly what it is. And we just put this here. Let me just take this, copy path, and I want to see how different it is based on the time it has taken. And it's like, you know, they're looking pretty decent. Oh my God. Oh my God. Come on. Don't do that. O1 mini is so much better. And I'm just like pasting the O1. I am like super excited to see what O1 comes up with. Oh my God. No, this can't be right. Like, this is just so much better. The only thing is I can't technically use this. There's like nothing happening yet. I'm not using some instructions, right? Okay. So how to play, start the game, up, down, left, or right. I am not able to control it. Okay, I'm able to control it finally. This is damn good. This is damn good, okay? But it's working better. This is GPT-4, okay? So honestly, I like the mini one a lot more, right? I just like the mini one a lot more. It's the same example, and I don't want to play the game. Press space to reach start. Okay, I need to use this. So there is no play button. I should have been a bit more descriptive, but honestly, UI-wise, no. Hands down, it's literally, so I'm just going to let it run. Hands down, it's literally best is O1 mini. Like this, like just look at the UI, and specifically, obviously, I think like UI is like 10 times better compared to all of them. So that's crazy good. And I'm like, obviously shocked that that just came in 15 seconds. That came in 15 seconds, an HTML game. I'm telling you, programming is cooked. Literally, it's cooked. Okay. So let's go next and see how it comes to. Okay. Now, the next one that I have is a bit more complex, right? Because they have said that it's really good for complex topics. So again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start a new chart. I'm going to bring into a new chart because I can always start with a fresh chart. When you're testing these things, you don't want to have any kind of bias. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to copy this crazy like prompt. Again, this might work. This might work to give probably great results. What I want to do is India is having an increase in unemployment. And I want, if any of these models can give something that is different, right? Like, you know, how to do that. And I've given it a couple of factors that it's because of education being a lot similar. So let's just go ahead and run it. So let's go 1, 2, 3. And they all have to give options on what government can do. Now, right now, I do expect O1 preview to work like at least twice better than compared to any other model right now, literally. So let's see. I'm not expecting crazy different answers. A lot of them similar, but I'm expecting the objections or like the arguments to be much better, right? So let's see. Okay. Enhanced education quality. ChatGPT-4o and like, you know, O1 preview looks very similar. I would preferably like, you know, like the content of O1 mini, the writing skills of O1 mini is just probably like better. So revamp the educational system, and that's pretty good. Curriculum reform, update educational curricula to include, update critical thinking, problem solving. And I think like that's pretty similar. Teacher training, public-private partnerships. Okay. I just want to keep like going down because a lot of this is very similar. So boost job creation, support for startups, skill development programs, and then, you know, enhance technical education, promote diverse employment, encourage entrepreneurship. So again, very similar answers, but just the content quality of writing of O1 Mini is better. So I think like in writing, O1 Mini like stands out, and that could be a real personal thing for me. But probably like, you know, you can say like, no, actually, I prefer O1 preview, and that's completely fine. That's up to you. But I prefer this. And also just like the amount of inputs that both of these models are getting is so much better, right? So GPT-4 will just give 4, and they both give at least 10 messages to each one of me, right? 10 inputs to all of this. So, and we can also, the best thing is we can see, okay, thought for a second, does not show anything. Thought for 5 seconds, and you can see identifying major issues, addressing unemployment, evaluating the job market, and you can see that you can also understand the reasoning behind it. A lot of people are saying it's just a prompt technique. They've just put a chain of thought model. I believe that a bit better than that, a bit better than the quality of the response that you're getting. Even though the thinking is a bit more here, or probably like thought from a time perspective better, the content on the left is similar. Again, I'm not expecting them to do some crazy stuff, but I would love to read these answers later and see if they are much more different than what we are already doing, or like, you know, it does not look like that right now, but maybe, right? So then the next question that I want to test on it, and I finally forgot to check the time, but it was pretty fast in the first one. And I really like check the time, but very simply explain three steps on how to reduce poverty drastically, because I want to test them on things that, you know, if we can use them in real life use cases, right? So let's go 3, 2, and 1. And I give like GPT mini, like even on seconds on better. Okay, awesome. It's already started responding, right? Both of them. So in 2 to 4 seconds, preview is taking a bit more longer of this. And 10 seconds, let's see how long it takes. And 13 seconds. Okay, so 13 seconds for them. GPT-4 is still going on. Let me see how fast they complete their answer. So 18 seconds for 4o and then another 22 seconds for preview. So preview obviously takes a bit more time. Now I give it a new thing. Like, you know, if you had to redefine the basic definition of poverty based on how much you earn, that's how they define, like, you know, if a person on this much per day, they are above or below poverty line in a lot of cases in like education and stuff. So let's see how much that is. And like, again, let's see what the idea is. Pretty similar answers: invest in equality education and everything, promote inclusive economic growth, strengthen social safety nets, enhance access. Again, obviously, like, you know, a lot of social causes to do that, promote inclusive job creation. But I really want to understand, like, you know, what does their basic definition of poverty changes to? Okay. Yep. I think this is like, okay, I don't know. I just read the answer. So you can see it less than like, you know, World Bank describes poverty as this. And the answer was like, you know, what will you redefine it to us? Because I don't think $2.15 per day is a good measure. Maybe it is. Again, I'm not an economist, but very simply, it needs to change, right? So the poverty line is set at $3.65. It still says that it's $6.85 per day. I want to go a bit deeper. Would you change the per day cost of living? Right? And I want to see how they respond as, you know, like, you know, just as a second option also. Would you change? Let's see. Thinking yes. Yes, I wanted to say yes. I want some of them to say yes and see, like, you know, no or something. Interesting, defining nuanced issue. Again, like, you know, this is taking 1 minute, took a very less, like, you know, a diplomatic answer. But yes, like, based on even 4o said, yes, I would change, and yes, I would change. And like, you know, you see the difference in the response and you see how it's going to change the way that we are using this content. Okay, so my battery is going low, but let me just pause for a second. Okay, so pretty good answers, right? But very simply, what I want to do is, like, you know, just see to the last part on how this is going to look. Okay, so what I want to do is pretty good answers in all of them, but I want to test, like, you know, probably the favorite question that this led to. And that is, like, very simply, how many R's are there in a strawberry, right? So let me just bring that and I'll tell you the final scores. Pretty much going to be super fast, right? And I just want to, like, you know, run that, just go for it. And there are, if you're referring something elsewhere, please let me know. I would be happy to help. So the letter R, there are 3 R's, and, like, you know, it probably gives you a breakdown or 1 mini, and there are 3 R's in the world. All 3 of them, I don't know. It's like they've updated GPT-4o to do that. And quick second, but I technically prefer that, you know, it was a breakdown and how it thought through is there. So this is crazy. What I came to conclusion as, and that was just a fun thing to do on the R's part, I think the mini is preferably usable a bit more on, like, in just simple prompts. Probably, like, I'm pretty sure, like, if we prompt O1 preview a bit better, it might change. But very simply, I think one mini is performing much, much better. And we can just do the sum. It's pretty much equal, right? Right now, it's all 2-2. Obviously, comparison to GPT-4 is not right because the model is a bit better in thought process based things. But even I would have preferred it to present, like, probably a better UI. It did not, like, you know, just do that. So that's my take on this. Like, let me know what you think. Please do follow me, subscribe to me, share this video. And also you can see a playlist of all the things, like, you know, comparison with other models. We're going to do that a lot more. And I would love to see you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.